Hey everybody, Shug here. What I want to talk to you about today is hammock suspension. That is the thing that keeps your hammock hanging. For something so simple as a piece of fabric that strings between two trees, it can be quite complex. So I want to go through some suspensions. I'm certainly not going to cover them all, but I'm going to cover most in a short video series where I do one or two at a time. I would like to point out that this whole video is really geared toward someone that's new at hammocks. All right, kind of a new hammocker that is researching all this stuff and maybe is just a little confused on the suspension. I'll touch a little bit on the angles of suspension and the rules of thumb on that. And you know, some people like to have their suspension straight out to the trees. That's their preferred way. You do have a lot of force though on the hammock, the suspension, and the trees then. The normal thing is to go up at approximately a 30 degree angle from the end of your hammock to the tree. You get a better hang that way for 99.9.3.27 of the human population. There's some people that just like to hang straight out, and cool, that's your thing, you go ahead and do it. I'm not here to tell you what to do. You do what you do, I do what I do. So I'm gonna start by showing a suspension. I don't use it personally. A lot of Enos come with it. The Atlas straps, the Eno straps, the Eno Atlas straps. It is called a daisy chain suspension. It's a series of loops within the webbing. I find it to be a heavier webbing because it's doubled. But the thing about suspension is a lot of people try to save weight there, and there is a difference. You know, straps, depending on the length of strap you want, daisy chain's heavier than just a regular Dyneema or a polyester strap. The word is nylon stretches a little bit. It does. I've tested it. I like the polyester, or some people call it a polypro strap, way less stretch. Whether you use as a tree strap, in a whoopee sling system with a marlin spike hitch and a toggle, that's my favorite. But come winter time, I go to my cinch buckles because I just don't like to take my gloves off. It's a little quicker. There's more things to do in the winter. Enough said on all this. Let's take a look at the daisy chain suspension. Mine is from Dutchware. I think it's one of the easier ways when you're starting out with a hammock, because like I said in the beginning, hammocks can be complex. And if you're a new hammocker, be patient. Get your hammock hung right. Figure your height. You can see me sitting right now. I like to sit where I can just put my feet on the ground. That's the perfect height for me. And that also, you know, when I get out at night, that works great. I like to sit in my hammock a lot when I'm at camp under my tarp, because I camp alone a lot and just kind of hang out. More often than not, I like to have breakfast from the hammock. So this height for me is perfect. I can have my breakfast, work it. A lot of people like their hammocks a lot higher. They kind of crawl up into their hammocks. Keep it simple in the beginning until you're familiar with your hammock and your insulation and your tarp hanging and your way. There are so many out there these days. I'm just gonna show you a few that I've used and that I really like. And I hope you find it's a little bit helpful in your hammock journey. So I have the continual loop coming off my hammock, or whatever type of hammock you have and whatever type of whipping you have on the end, there'll usually be something to hook a suspension into. Now with this one, I'm using the beaner, and as you can see in this webbing, all the way along, there are these loops like this. That goes all the way up and down the suspension, one here. So there's one about every 3-4 inches, one there, one there. So it's a series of loops. That means your webbing is doubled all the way. All right, so it is a heavier one. I happen to have 15 feet here. I just ordered that. You know, I always say order it long. It's easy enough to cut it off. Maybe I only want 10 on each side. Well, I would just cut it off and then take a lighter and just kind of melt your webbing so it doesn't fray. And that's a way to lose a little weight on your webbing suspension. This is 2 15-foot daisy chain straps from Dutchware gear. There they are compared to a sort of a Camelback Nalgene bottle, and the weight of them will be 2 together 423 grams. That would be 14.90 ounces. So a little bit one of the heavier suspensions that you use. Plus, you know, add your carabiners to that, you're gonna put on just a little bit more weight. Here we are at 14.90 ounces. We'll add 2 carabiners to that. That brings us up to basically 468 grams, and that's 1 pound, 5 ounces. Right there. So it's a fairly bulky suspension, but simple, and pretty idiot-proof in the beginning. So that is your daisy chain webbing. And I just looped it through itself here at the end. But let's break it down and look at a couple of ways we could hook it up. So this will be where I put it around the tree, like this. And in this case, here's the long end of my webbing, there's my loop, and I'm just gonna thread it through. This is probably your most common way. Now, since we're here, let me just tell you this. Because my webbing is coming off this side of my tree, I want to keep it to that side because it puts way less stress on this loop as opposed if I go this way. If I come to this side of the tree with it, you can see my webbing is pulling back on itself really hard. And once you put some weight in the hammock, it'll slide over this way a little bit, but you're really stressing the end of your webbing or your bean or whatever. So always have it to the side of the tree like this. So there's not a lot of weight on this area. It's holding it where it needs to be without stressing it. So your next option really is just to take this loop, instead of looping your webbing through, is to put a beaner on it like this, come around your tree, and simply just hook your beaner like that. Same thing. You want it coming from the side of the tree here, so there's not a lot of stress on the beaner. You don't want it over here because you're just gonna put a lot more stress pulling on that beaner and your straps. So that's your way right there. The one thing is you'll have to carry another beaner or a way to hook it to your hammock, but these are light enough. That's a simple way. That is a Camp Nano beaner. You can see that right there. That is a strong beaner for your hammock suspension. And a nano beaner weighs 0.80 of an ounce, 22 grams. Again, another reason for using a beaner or a Dutch beaner here is to be able to unhook this more quickly once your hammock's all set up, if your hang is not right, and to move it up around some limbs or something. You know, perhaps there's a limb sticking out that side. Usually they're around the back, and if you weave it through, you got to undo the whole thing, unloop it, and go up around again. So this makes it really easy to do. It's really just the main reason for doing that. Okay, now we're going to take a look at the Dutch clip on there. It's called the Dutch clip. So where that beaner was, you can see the Dutch clip has a shape where one side is a little bit longer and there's a little notch right there. That's the part that goes onto your webbing, and that is held on there. I don't tape mine or sew mine. They hold, and it kind of goes on in that configuration like that. All right? And then this other open part will just act like the carabiner does. And that's going to work like this. So now again, I go around my tree, and I have this part right there, and I'm just gonna hook my webbing up through that, and just like the beaner, that's gonna hold my webbing. Again, try to keep it on this side of the tree so it's not pulling against this, as opposed to having it this way where it's really putting a lot more stress on the Dutch clip. This is my preferred way, and it's really easy. Same thing, you unhook it and can move it up and down the tree a lot easier. Bada boom. The titanium Dutch clip weighs 0.3 ounces, so not even an ounce, and it is 9 grams, so very light. So from here it's pretty simple. I have my carabiner on the end of my continual loop. This strap, like I say, has loops all along it. I can eyeball my hammock. I like my foot end a little bit higher, so I'm just going to clip it through that loop right there, and it's as easy as that. Just about perfect. And next installment, we'll look at one of the other suspensions. I think we're gonna go with your J-bend and your Beckett hitch or cinch buckles. So stay tuned for more hammock suspensions.
all secure in Sector 7.